Shalom, shalom, shalom. Most High bless, Most High bless. This is Kuanaf, Yehuda, and Kahan. This topic is going to may surprise a lot of you guys because, you know, it's different breakdowns, so on and so forth. So the brother Yehuda was telling me about this, and I said, okay, I'll take a listen. And I listened. I said, you know what? I think everybody need to hear this. So just open up your mind and get the increase. Most High will. So you want to say something before we start?
Yes, sir. Grace and peace. Shalom to everybody. This is your brother Yehuda. And yes, Kunaf and I, we basically went over the 144,000, right? Kunaf about a week ago. Yes, and sir. I showed him some scriptures, right? And he pretty much agreed with what I was showing him, right? So he said, you know what? Let's just bring it to the people and let the people decide. You understand? Excuse me, I have a little head.
Right.
Let the people decide, right? So that's what we're going to do. Right. We're just going to go through the scriptures, who the 144,000 is, right? Because there are a lot of speculations. Some people say that it is the present Negroes that's living today, etc. So it's a lot of different rumors flowing around on who is the 144,000, right? So what we're going to do, we're just going to basically go through the Bible, go through the scriptures, and we're going to let you judge for yourself. That's what we're going to do.
Right.
I'm not going to pressure anybody to believe what I bring out. I just want you to go to the scriptures. Write these scriptures down and examine them for yourselves, right? And then you can come to your own conclusion. Excuse me. Right? Your own conclusion, right? So first, what I want to do first is go to Deuteronomy, the first chapter.
Go ahead, unmute your mic, brother, so we get ready.
Deuteronomy, the first chapter. Yep. Like I said, listen, you can basically, I'm not here to force this lesson on anybody. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, you can come to your own conclusion, you know, once it's all said and done, right? So let's go to Deuteronomy, the first chapter, and let's read verse 39, because it's a lot of speculation on who is the 144,000, right? Let's go to Deuteronomy, the first chapter, and when you get there, right, read verse 39.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1, and verse 39. Moreover, your little ones, which ye have said, should be a prey, and your children, which in that day had no knowledge between good and evils, they shall go in thither, and unto them will I give it, and they shall possess it.
Right, but so here, right here, God is telling the Jews and Joshua, etc., that the children, it says, moreover, your little ones, which ye said they should be a prey, and your children, which is in that day, had no knowledge between good and evil. That's very important, right? Because we know that the kids, little ones, the children, the toddlers and babies, they have no knowledge of good and evil, right? They have no fault. They don't know right from wrong, correct?
Con,
I mean, we all understand this. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, I was saying, Con, the key also, it says little ones is very key, right?
Exactly.
Like it. Go ahead. You're right.
Exactly. So basically, he's saying here that many of you Jews will not cross over the Jordan River, but your little ones, they will cross over because they have no knowledge of good and evil, right? No knowledge of good and evil. So keep that in mind. They are without fault. without fault, right? Yeah. So basically says, as for you, if you rebelled, right, you rebelled and will not listen to the Lord. And matter of fact, read verses 41 through 46.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter.
In fact, no, read verse 40 through
46. Con. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1 and verse 40.
Yeah.
But as for you, turn you and take your journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea.
Right.
Verse 41. Then ye answered and said unto me, we have sinned against the Lord. We will go up and fight according to all that the Lord our God commanded us. And when ye had girded on every man his weapon of war, ye were ready to go up into the hill.
Okay, you know what? Stop right there, bro. So it says that they told God, we have sinned. We sinned. But notice, God says that your little ones, the babies, the toddlers, the children, they shall cross over. They shall enter the promised land because they are without fault. They don't know good from evil and right from wrong, right? Now, we're not going to read all the rest of the verses. Jump to verse 46. Read verse 46.
Verse 46. So ye abode in Kadesh many days, according unto the days that ye abode there.
Right, exactly. We can continue to read Deuteronomy, the second chapter. It talks about the wilderness and the Red Sea, etc. But the key is, God says that your little ones, they will enter the promised land because they have no fault. They don't know right from wrong. They don't know good from evil. They are innocent. Now let's go to the book of Numbers, right? Let's take a look at the book of Numbers. In fact, when you get there, right, go to book of Numbers 14. Go to chapter 14, right? And when you get there, right, read verse 31.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 14, verse 31. But your little ones, which ye said should be a prey, them will I bring in, and they shall know the land which ye have despised.
Right. So this is more confirmation that God says that your little ones that you said will be a prey upon the enemies, they will enter the promised land because they have no fault. They don't know right from wrong, etc. Right now, let's go to 2 Samuel. In fact, do me a favor, bro. Stay right there in the book of Numbers, right? And read verse 3. Numbers chapter 14, right? Back up and read verse 3.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 14 and verse 3. And wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land to fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey? Were it not better for us to return into Egypt?
Right. Now go back one more time and read verse 31 one more time. Verse 31.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 14 and verse 31. But your little ones, which ye said should be a prey, them will I bring in, and they shall know the land which ye have despised.
Which you said shall be a prey, they will enter the promised land because they have no fault. Now let's go to 2 Samuel. The little ones have no fault. They are without fault, and they are innocent. They don't know right from wrong. They don't know the difference between good and evil, as God says in Deuteronomy, the first chapter, and verse 39. He said they are innocent, right? So listen, when you get to 2 Samuel, right, go to chapter 12.
2 Samuel chapter 12.
And read verse 23.
Con. This the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 12 and verse 23. But now he is dead.
Now, let me stop you right there. This is when David's son died because he slept with Bathsheba. So God punished David by taking away his son. This is what this is talking about here. All right, so go ahead and read.
2 Samuel, chapter 12 and verse 23. But now he is dead. Wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I should go to him, but he shall not return to me.
So wait a minute. David says his son that God took away from him because of what he did by sleeping with Bathsheba. He says right here, he says, can I bring him back again? And then he says, and I shall go to him. He said, I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. So the question is now, how is David going to go to his son? When his son died, right? He said, I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. David is saying, when I die, my spirit will go to heaven to be with him. Because when kids die, when toddlers die, when babies die, their spirit automatically goes to heaven. So David says, how can I bring him back again, right? And I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. He shall never return on earth while I'm here. But when I die, I shall go to him in heaven. Now let's go to the book of Luke. Let's go to Luke. So David says, I'm going to be with my son once I die. Because his spirit is in heaven during the time of David and as we speak. So let's go to the book of Luke. Right? Let's take a look at this, right? Let's go to Luke. Chapter 18. David says, he shall not come to me, but when I die, I shall go to him. Book of Luke, chapter 18, read verses 15 and 16.
Luke 18 and 15. And they brought unto him also infants that he would touch them. But when his disciples saw it, they rebuked him.
Stop right there. It says that these women, they brought their babies and toddlers to the Messiah, right? And he said that his disciples, they rebuked them for bringing their babies to him. Read verse 16.
Verse 16. But Yahushua called them unto him and said, suffer little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God.
Exactly. He said, suffer them to come unto me and forbid them not. But notice, right? His disciples, they rebuked these women for bringing their children to the Messiah. And Christ says, suffer them to come unto me. But let the children come to me and do not hinder them, right? Now let's go to Matthew, right? Let's go to Matthew chapter 19.
Gotcha.
I mean, can you believe that? Can you believe that, though? That the disciples rebuked these women for bringing their little ones to the Messiah.
Terrible.
He says, suffer the little ones to come to me. Do not hinder them from coming to me. Let's go to Matthew 19, right? Read verses 13 and 14.
Come, this is the book of St. Matthew, chapter 19, verse 13. But where they're brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked him. But
they did
Yahusha
what?
Said, but
they rebuked them, right?
Right.
So it's just basically the same story They rebuke these women for bringing their children to the Messiah. Read verse 14.
Verse 14. But Yahweh Shah said, suffer little children and forbid them not to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven.
And such is the kingdom of heaven. Such is the kingdom of heaven. That's why David says that my son that God took away from me because of my sin, that I shall he shall not come to me, but I shall go to him, because his son's spirit went straight to heaven. Even though his son was born out of wedlock, it was not his son's fault. It was not his fault that he was born out of wedlock. So he went straight to heaven. His spirit went straight to heaven. Right? So Christ said again, he said, suffer the little ones to forbid them not to come unto me, for as such is the kingdom of heaven. And then he read verse 15.
Verse 15. And he laid his hands on them and departed thence.
And he laid his hands on them and departed. Now let's go to back up, right? Back up one chapter and go to Matthew 18 and read verses 1 through 4.
Matthew chapter 18, verses 1. At the same time came the disciples unto Yahweh Shah, saying, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? Verse 2. And Yahweh Shah called the little child unto him, and he set him in the midst of them. Verse 3. And said, verily, I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Verse 4, whosoever therefore shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoso shall receive one such little child in my name receiveth me.
So he said that we must be humble as the little ones in order to enter into heaven. Okay, that's crystal clear. Now read verse 10. Jump down to verse 10 and read verse 10.
Book of St. Matthew chapter 18 and verse 10. Take heed that ye despise not one of these little children. For I say unto you that in heaven their angels do always behold the face of my Father which is in heaven.
He says, take heed. Now I want many of you to listen to this now, because I've seen people many times look upon kids with disgust. This with a disgust look. He said, take heed that ye despise not one of these little ones, for I say unto you that in heaven their angels do always behold the face of my Father which is in heaven. That's why David says that my son shall not return to me, but I shall go to him when I die. Because David knew that his son, born out of wedlock, right? His spirit went to heaven. David knew this right here. So Christ said again, take heed that ye despise not one of these little ones, because their angels always see my Father's face in heaven. Always. Now let's go to the book of Mark. Because we are trying to establish who is the 144,000. Like I said, right? You don't have to believe what I'm putting out here. Just examine these scriptures, right? And go back and check them out yourself. That's all you have to do. Excuse me. And go to the book of Mark, right? And read verses 36 and 37.
Mark chapter what? What chapter?
Chapter 9.
Chapter 9. So Mark chapter 9, 36 and 37.
Yes, sir.
This is the book of St. Mark, chapter 9, and verse 36. And he took a child and set him in the midst of them. And when he had taken him in his arms, he said unto them, whosoever shall receive one of such children in my name receiveth me. And whosoever shall receive me, receive not me, but him that sent me.
You see that? Said, whosoever welcomes one of these little children in my name, they welcome me. So I'm just showing everybody that Christ loved the children. He loved the toddlers and the baby. He said, do not hurt one of these little ones. If you do, you're going to answer to him. And do not look upon them with despisement. as if you despise them. He said that their faces always behold the face of his Father in heaven. Always. Let's go to Psalms 127. Psalms 127, right? When you get there, right? When you get there, read verse 3.
You said Psalms 127.
Yes, sir.
Psalms 127, verse 3, you said.
Verse 3. That's correct.
The book of Psalms, David, chapter 127 and verse 3. Lo, children are inheritance of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward.
You see that? The fruit of the womb is his reward, right? Now let's go to Psalms 8 and read verse 2. Chapter 8, read verse 2. Because we are trying to see who is 144,000. That people that say that we are the elect. We here on earth, we are the elect. We are the 144,000, right? I know you all heard many Negroes say we are the 144,000. Let's go to Psalms 8, right? Read verse 2. In fact, read verse 1 and 2.
Psalm chapter 8, verse 1. O Lord, uh-huh. O Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Verse 2. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightiest steal the enemy and the avenger.
You see that? Now, some translations actually says through the praise of children, the infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies. Now let's go back to Matthew, right? Go to Matthew 18. Excuse me. Go to Matthew 18, right? And read verse 4. Yeah, because we trying to establish who is the 144,000 according to the Bible, according to the manuscript. Not according to our feelings or who we want to be, the 144,000, but according to the word of the Most High himself. Matthew 18 and read verse 4.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 18 and verse 4. Whosoever shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven.
Now, okay, exactly. I gotta reestablish that one more time. Let's go to the book of Mark. Go to Mark 10. Mark 10, right? And read verse 15.
Got it.
Yeah, the book of Mark, chapter 10, read verse 15.
This is the book of Mark, chapter 10, and verse 15. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein.
I gotta reestablish that. Let's go to one more. Before we jump into the book of Revelation, let's go to 1 Peter. 1 Peter, right? Which is also a keeper. Peter. Let's go to 1 Peter, right? Go to chapter 2 and read verses 1 and 2.
This is the book of 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 1, right?
Yeah, 1 through 2, yeah. 1. Exactly.
Wherefore, laying all aside all malice and all guile, all hypocrisies and envies, and all evil speakings, as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
Exactly. So Christ has established that we must be as a newborn baby and humble as a child to enter to heaven. He says whenever they die, he said their spirit automatically go to heaven. He said they always behold the face of his Father. Now let's get to the nitty gritty, right? The nitty gritty, as my uncle likes to say. Let's go to Revelation now. Let's go to Revelation 7 and 4, right? Christ is not playing around. When he's dealing with children, he's not playing. He said, "Do not despise the little one, Don't despise them, because their faces always behold the face of his Father in heaven. Go to Revelation chapter 7.
7 and 3, right?
Hold on for a second. Actually, 7. Let me get there real quick. Revelation 7, right? Let's see here. Read. Bear with me for a second. Read verse 4. In fact, you know what? No, what? No. Read verse 1 through 4.
Come. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 7, and verse 1. Uh-huh. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads.
Okay, read verse four.
Come. And I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel.
It says, these things I saw four angels. Keep that in mind, because we're going to go right back to this. Four angels holding the four winds. Keep that in mind also, because we're going right back to that. Right? He said, I saw another angel ascended from the east. Keep that in mind also, because we're going back to that. Now, real quick, what I want to do, hold your spot right there, right? Let's go to 2 Chronicles. I want to show everybody something real quick here. Go to 2 Chronicles, right? Second. When you get to 2 Chronicles, do me a favor. Read, go to 2 Chronicles chapter 13. Let's take a look at something here, right? Because these Negroes say that the 10 tribes, or the Jews within the 10 tribes, did not go back to the homeland, right? After the captivity, right? That's what they say. Go to 2 Chronicles. So we're going to kill that lie right here real quick. Go to 2 Chronicles, right? When you get to chapter 13, right? Let me see here. No, my bad. 1 Chronicles, right? And go to chapter 9. 1 Chronicles chapter 9. And when you get there, read verses 1 through 3.
1 Chronicles chapter 9, verse 1. So all Israel were reckoned by genealogies, and behold, they were written in the book of the kings of Israel and Judah, who were carried away to Babylon for the transgression. Verse 2. Now the first inhabitants that dwell in their possessions.
Stop right there. Is that the first who?
The first inhabitants.
These are the inhabitants that returned with Zerubbabel to rebuild the temple. It was three waves of return. Zerubbabel first to go back and to rebuild the temple. Some years later, Ezra led many Jews back. And then after him, Nehemiah led many Jews back. But these are the Jews that came back with Zerubbabel among the first group. Now continue to read. Let's see what Jews went back with the first group.
Start at verse 2 again. Now these were the first inhabitants that dwelled in their possessions, and their cities were the Israelites, the priests, the Levites, and the Nehathims. What's that?
Nethinims. Yep. Go ahead.
Nethinims. Verse 3. And in Jerusalem dwelled of the children of Judah, and the children of Benjamin, and the children of Ephraim and Manasseh.
And the children of who?
And the children of Judah, and the children of Benjamin, and the children of Ephraim and Manasseh.
So you're telling me that you had Hispanics dwelling in Judah after with the first group that went back. You had Hispanics dwelling in Judah. That's what you're telling me. Because according to Josephus, he wrote that the Jews, they look what's the word looking for? There was a very dark people, Josephus wrote. There was a Suti, that's the word I'm looking for. He said they were a Suti looking people, Josephus said. And Herodotus said the exact same thing. They was black. So you have these Ephraimites and children from Ephraim and Manasseh, they went back with the first group. So that kills that lie. Also, that Hispanics are the Israelites, because Josephus said that they was a black skinned people. Let's go back to Revelation. Go back to Revelation.
Come on, I'm there.
Yeah, when you get to Revelation, right? Go to chapter 14.
Come on, Revelation chapter 14. What verse you want?
Read verses 1 through 4.
Come on, Revelation chapter 14 and verse 1. And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on the mount Sion, and with him 144,000 having his father's name written in their foreheads. Verse 2. And I heard a voice from heaven as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of a great thunder. And I heard the voice of harpers harping with their harps. And they sung as it were a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders. And no man could learn that song but the 144,000, which were redeemed from the earth. Verse 4.
Hey, stop right there. So right here, the angel is showing John a vision of what was going on in heaven at his time when he was on the island of Patmos. When he was on the island of Patmos, the angel was showing him a vision. So he was seeing what was going on at his time in heaven. So during the time of John, we had a revelation on the island of Patmos. He saw the 144,000 in heaven. He saw them. Right? Now read verse 4, but read it kind of slow.
Verse 4. These are they which were not defiled with women.
These are they. This is one clue. I want everybody to write this down. These are they that which were not defiled by women. Right? Only not defiled by women. We all been defiled. Everybody. I don't care if you married. We all been defiled by women.
Yep.
Every man being defiled by women if you're not a virgin. But for the most part. You want to say something about
No, go ahead. You getting it. Go ahead.
That is the first clue. Read the next sentence.
For they are virgins.
For they are who?
For they are virgins.
They are virgins, right? That's the second clue. Continue.
These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth.
Stop right there. Now, John is seeing this vision in heaven. The angel is showing John the vision. He can see what's going on. He see these 144,000 following the Messiah everywhere he go. That's another clue. They following him everywhere he go. Keep reading.
These were redeemed from among men.
These were redeemed from among men on the earth. So these 144,000, they were on the earth right before they went up to heaven. When John saw these 144,000 through the vision, they were on the earth. Keep reading.
These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb.
Being the first fruits unto God and the Lamb. The first, keep that in mind, that is another clue. They were the first fruits unto God, meaning the Messiah, and to the Lamb. They were the first fruits. That's another clue. Go ahead and read verse 5.
Verse 5. And in their mouth was found no guile.
Stop right there. It says, in their mouths were found no guile. Read the next sentence.
For they are without fault.
For they are without fault. Did not God tell King David that your little ones will enter the promised land because they had no fault? They did not know good from evil. That's another clue. They had no fault. They knew they did not know right from wrong, like little one, like your children, toddlers. They don't know right from wrong. They had no fault. Okay, we all have fault. Once we become adolescents, we all have fault. We all sin. Once we become older and adults, we all have fault. We all sin. Ain't no getting around it. Okay, nobody on this comment board or listening to this lesson tonight can tell me that you don't have fault. We all have fault, but the little ones, like Christ says, he said that their faces always see my Father's face in heaven because they are without fault. That's another clue. Continue to read. Read verse 5. Read verse 5 one more time.
Come. And in their mouth was found no guile, for they are without fault before the throne of God.
Exactly. Now, like I said, you don't have to believe what I'm putting out here. Just examine these scriptures for yourselves and go back, right? And just look at it yourself. I'm not forcing this on nobody. Let's go to Isaiah 53.
Brother Yuda, I've read this verse before, and I've heard they said that this was that the 144, they was like, this is just you talking about eunuchs.
Well, let's see.
We're gonna get into that.
Go to Isaiah 53, right? Start reading verse 1. We're gonna read all the way to verse 10.
Come. Let me get to Isaiah. Isaiah 53.
Hey, let me stop it right there. They say, I've heard that argument before too, where they said these are eunuchs, right? Eunuchs. But you have to understand, eunuchs sin. They may be eunuchs without a man organ, but guess what? They still sinners. They are not without fault.
Done.
Okay. Once you become an adolescent, you have the sin gene already born when you're born anyway. Right, so when you become older, guess what? You start to know right from wrong. Right, you start to know. You start to know good from evil. So they still were sinners, regardless. Even the eunuchs were sinners, right? So you can throw that out the window. Let's go to Isaiah 53, right? Read and start reading verse 1. We're going to read down to verse 10.
So Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 1. Have believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed?
Talking about the Messiah. Who has believed our report? Go ahead, verse 2.
For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness.
Right.
And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire of him. Verse 3. He is despised and rejected of men, and man of sorrows, and acquainted with grief. And we hid as it was were our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Verse 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed.
Exactly. Continue.
Verse 6, Uh-huh. All we like sheep have gone astray.
Right.
Turn everyone to his own way. And the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all.
Uh-huh.
He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth.
Right.
He had brought up, he had brought as a lamb to slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is dumb, so he opened not his mouth.
Verse okay, eight. Verse 8.
Verse 8. He was uh-huh. taken from prison and from judgment, and whom shall declare his generation?
Stop right there. Stop right there. It says, and he, in verse 8, and he, the Messiah, was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? Who shall declare his generation? And let me repeat that one more time. Who shall declare his generation? Who were Christ's generation? Who was his generation? Continue to read.
For he was cut off out of the land of the living.
For let me stop you there. Who shall declare his generation? And who? And it says, and he was cut off out of the land of the living. He was cut off. But it says, but here's the key. Here's the key. Who shall declare his generation? None. Who is Christ's generation? Right?
It's none of us.
It says, who shall declare his generation? Meaning, who shall remember his generation? Because it seems that we all forgot about his generation. Let's go to the book of Matthew. Let's go to the book of Matthew, right? And you folks can continue to read verse 9 and 10. It just talks about the Messiah and his seed, etc. But it says, who shall declare his generation? And it says, for he was cut off out of the land of the living. He was murdered. He was crucified, cut off, crucified. But who shall declare his generation? Let's go to Matthew chapter 2. Matthew 2, right? In fact, let me get there. I'm telling you to get there. I haven't even got there yet. Matthew 2, read verses 13 through 16. And let us all see who was Christ's generation that we did not declare, that we forgot about. Let's see who we totally forgot about. Read verses 13 through 16.
Matthew chapter 2 and verse 13. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, uh-huh. Arise and take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word. Uh-huh. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. Verse 14. When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night and departed uh-huh. into Egypt. Verse 15. Uh-huh. And was there until the death of Herod.
Uh-huh.
There that it may not Salaki, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken out of the Lord by the prophet, saying, out of Egypt I have called my son. Then right. Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men,
uh-huh.
was exceedingly wroth, and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in the coast thereof from 2 years.
Stop right there. And he slew Herod. Now I want you guys to think about something, right? The Messiah, Joseph, the angel told Joseph to take Mary and the Messiah when he was a baby into Egypt to hide. And Herod, it said that, and he slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and all the coast, meaning all of Judea, just to kill one baby. He took a chance to slaughter many babies to kill one child. That's why in the book of Revelation, it says that the 144,000 are the first fruits. They the first fruits unto Christ. Let me continue. And slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in all the coast thereof from 2 years old and under, according to the time which had diligently inquired of the wise men. Let me continue to read. I continue to read. Okay. Verse so it says that he slew all of these children, right? Just to kill one baby. Mm. All of these innocent babies slaughtered for no reason. Well, it was a reason why, but they were slaughtered on the account of the Messiah. Now, with that being said, hold your thought right there, right? Let's go to Genesis chapter 30. Hold your spot right there. Now, I want all of you to think about this, right? Because it says, who shall declare his generation? Isaiah says, who shall declare his generation? Who shall remember his generation? So we forget about all those babies that were slaughtered on the account of the Messiah. That's how paranoid Herod, he was so paranoid, he slaughtered hundreds and thousands of babies just to kill one baby. Let's go to Genesis 30, right? When you get there, like we're gonna read verses 1-8.
Come, this is the first book of Moses called Genesis, chapter 30 and verse 1. And when Rachel saw that she bare Jacob no children, Rachel envied her sister and said unto Jacob, give me children or else I die.
Right.
Verse 2. And Jacob's anger was kindled against Rachel. And he said, am I in God's stead? Who have withheld from thee the first fruit of the womb? And she said, behold, my maid, Bilhah, go unto her, and she shall bear upon my knees, that I may also have children by her.
And right, so Bilhah was Rachel's maid, and she had children by her. Now read verses 5 and 6.
Verses 5 and 6. And Bilhah conceived and bare Jacob a son.
Right.
Verse 6. And Rachel said, God hath judged me and hath also heard my voice and hath given me a son. Therefore called she his name Dan.
So who named Dan?
Rachel.
Rachel. Dan was Rachel's adopted son. Bilhah was Dan's legal maternal mother, but Rachel was Dan's legal mother. Right? So Rachel named Dan. Now read verses 7 and 8.
Verse 7. And Rachel's maid conceived again and bare Jacob a second son. Verse 8. And Rachel said with great wrestlings, I have wrestled with my sister and I have prevailed. And she called his name Naphtali.
So Rachel adopted Dan and Naphtali, and she named them. And she also bore Joseph and Benjamin. Keep that in mind. So technically, Dan, Naphtali, Joseph, and Benjamin was Rachel's sons. Now let's go back to the book of Matthew, chapter two. Let's go back. I want to show everybody. Rachel named Dan and Naphtali. Dan and Naphtali was Rachel's adopted sons. Those were her sons also, along with Joseph and Benjamin. Now go back to Matthew 2, right? So we just read in verse 16 that Herod slew all these babies from Bethlehem and all the coast. He slew all these babies. Now read verse 17 and 18.
Verses 17 and 18 of Matthew. Then was fulfilled that which was spoken by Jeremy the prophet. I guess it's right. Jeremiah.
Verse 18. In fact, read verse 18. I didn't mean to cut you off. Yeah, go ahead. Verse 18.
In Ramah was there a voice heard lamentation and weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children.
Rachel weeping for who?
Rachel weeping for her children.
Now remember, I showed you guys that Ephraim, Manasseh, and the Israelites went back with the first group. So all the tribes were dwelling in the land. So it says that Rachel weeping for her children. Right? Rachel weeping for her children. Naphtali, Joseph, Benjamin, and also Joseph had Ephraim, and Ephraim represented the northern kingdom. It says that Rachel weeping for her children. And then it says that was spoken of by Jeremy the prophet, right? Now let's go to Jeremiah chapter 31.
Jeremiah
31. When you get to Jeremiah 31, read verse 15. This is what Matthew was talking about right here. This is the prophecy right here.
Jeremiah
31, right? Read verse 15.
Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 15. Thus saith the Lord, a voice was heard in Ramah, lamentation and bitter weeping. Rahel, which is Rachel, weeping for her children, refused to be comforted for her children because they were not.
Okay. It said that she refused to be comforted because her children were not, right? Meaning they were slaughtered, right? But check this out. Watch this, though. Watch this. Read verse 16.
Verse 16. Thus says the Lord, refrain thy voice from weeping and thine eyes from tears, for thy work shall be rewarded, saith the Lord. And they shall come again from the land of the enemy.
Read verse 17 also.
Verse 17. And there is hope in thine end, saith the Lord, that thy children shall come again to their own border.
It says that Rachel weeping for her children, right? But it says, weep not. It says, weep not, for thy work shall be rewarded, says the Lord, and they shall come again from the land of their enemies. And this is a dual prophecy right here. They're going to return, it says, after the captivity above the Euphrates from the Babylonian and the Assyrian captivity, they're going to return again. But it also, I'm going to show you guys something else. So it says, and there is hope in thy end, says the Lord, that the children shall come again to their own border. Now let's go back to Revelation 7. It says, Rachel weeping for her children, but weep not because they are going to return again. And soon we're going to see how they return. Revelation 7, right? Read verse 1.
Revelation chapter 7 and 1. And after these things, I saw four angels sitting on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. Verse 2.
He said, I saw an angel standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth. Right? Holding the four winds of the earth. And verse 2 says, and I saw another angel ascending from the east. Right? And now remember, right? When you look at a map, right? When John had his vision, he was on the island of Patmos, right? Right? And he says, I saw another angel ascending from the east. He was talking about towards the area of Judea. He was talking about the area of Judea and Jerusalem in that area, right? And then it says, and he cried out with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea. Now read verse 3.
Verse 3, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads.
He says, hurt not these, okay, because these will be raised from the sleep. They will be the first to be raised to be sealed before any other human on earth. Why? Because they were the first fruits of Christ, the first fruits. Go to Revelation 14, right? Revelation chapter 14 and read verse 4. Revelation chapter 14 and verse 3.
Verse 4.
Revelation chapter 14 and verse 4. These are they which were not defiled with women, but they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men. First fruits unto God and to the Lamb.
The first fruits unto God and the Lamb. Now let me read Revelation 7 and 1 one more time, and then we go to Ezekiel. Revelation 7, verse 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth. But here's the key, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. Now, let's go to Ezekiel 37.
The valley of the dry bones.
Valley of the dry bones. Yep.
Gotcha. Ezekiel chapter 37 in what verse?
Start reading. You know what? Start reading. Let me see here. Where I want to start at? Hold on. I was in the wrong book. Hold on one second. I was in the wrong book myself. Read verse 1.
Ezekiel chapter 37 and verse 1. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were mainly in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. Verse 3, and he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Verse 4, and he said unto me, prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Verse 5, thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you.
Let me stop you there. It says, these dry bones, I will cause breath to enter into you. Okay, continue to read. Verses 6 through, continue to verse 9.
Verse 6. And I will lay sinews. I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 7, so I prophesied as I was commanded, and I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone.
Verse 8.
And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them.
So it says the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. But watch what look what it says here in verse 9. Read verse 9.
Verse 9. Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind. Prophesy, son of man. And say unto the wind, thus said the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live.
It says, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds. It says the four winds, correct? Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live. Come from the four winds. Now, with that being said, go back to Revelation.
What you want there? Revelation 7?
Revelation 7. You know exactly where I'm going. It says, come from the four winds and breathe unto these so they may live. Right? Read Revelation 7 and verse 1 one more time.
Revelation chapter 7 and verse 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree.
Right, exactly. So it says the four winds, those four winds, right? They blew upon those dry bones, but those dry bones were the first fruit. It said that's why it says continue. Matter of fact, read verses 2-4 one more time.
2-4, come. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels. Salaki. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels, to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea. Verse 3, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our gods in their forehead.
They said, hurt not the earth, right? Nor the trees, etc., until we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads. Right? These servants, these were all of those babies slain on the account of the Messiah. They were the first fruits. They were the first fruits. Right? But people may say, but what about the tribe of Dan? We're almost done too. They may say, what about the tribe of Dan? The reason why Dan was not included in the 144,000 is because Dan had already migrated to Ethiopia. The tribe of Dan migrated to Ethiopia long before the Assyrian captivity. That's the only reason why Dan was not mentioned. I heard some people say, oh, Dan's not mentioned among 144,000 because Dan went to idols. But guess what? All the tribes went to idols.
Come.
Dan had already migrated to Ethiopia. So there were no babies to be slain by Herod in that land of Judea because the tribe of Dan had already migrated. But guess what? God said, Dan is going to be in the new kingdom. Let's go to, we're almost done. Let's go to, it said Dan is going to be in the new kingdom. Let's go to Romans 11 and read verse 1.
Come.
Hallelujah.
Come. I've always had questions on Dan. But Romans 11 and 1. I say then, have God, this a cut to that. I say then, have God cast away his people? God forbid. Right. For I am also an Israelite of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin.
For I am also an Israelite. He said, have God cast away his people? He said, God forbid. God did not cast away Dan. See, people have to get some biblical scholarship. I'm gonna tell you one reason why Dan, the tribe of Dan decided to leave because they also did not want to fight against the tribe of Judah. See, sometimes you have to go outside the Bible to get more scholarship, right? So the tribe of Dan, they had migrated long before Herod the Great killed all those babies. That's why you don't see Dan among the 144,000. Dan was not the only tribe that went to Ai. All the tribes went into idols. All the tribes. They all did. So Romans 11, it says, God has not cast away his people. And let's prove it. Let's go to Ezekiel. Let's go to Ezekiel, and then we're going to go back to Revelation. Revelation one more time, we'll be done. Let's go to Ezekiel 48. Let me show you what God says about the tribe of Dan, because God has not put away his people.
I think I already know what you want. You want 48 and
you want 48 and read verse 1.
Oh, come.
It's comical to me. It's comical to me how they don't have Dan on that lion ass 12 tribe chart when Dan is going to be mentioned first by the Most High. Because guess what? The last shall be first, and the first shall be last. Read Ezekiel 48 and verse 1.
Come, this is the book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 48 and verse 1. Now, these are the names of the tribes from the north end of the coast of the way of Kedron, as one goeth to Hamath, Hazar Anah, the border of Damascus northward, to the coast of Hamath, for these are his side east and west, a portion for Dan. Dan.
A portion for who?
A portion for Dan.
How ironical is that? God lists Dan first in the new kingdom. God didn't put away Dan. He mentioned Dan first. How they don't have Dan on that lion-ass chart? God mentions Dan. He mentioned Dan first. How ironic is that? Mentions Dan first. Go back to, now let's go back to, hold this. Go to Revelation 27 and read verse 12. Let's see about the gates, because Dan also have a gate.
Revelation 12, right? I'm sorry.
Revelation 27 and read verse 12.
Revelation 27 and verse 12. You said 12. Revelation 27?
Revelation, yeah.
Revelation's only got 22 chapters.
Well, wait a minute.
22.
I might write it down. Hold on a second. That was, oh, that's right.
Do you want Ezekiel chapter 48 and 32 where it talks about Dan getting the gate?
No, I was gonna go back to there. You know what? Yeah, go back and read that real quick, because it also mentions the gates. I think it's Revelation 22.
Revelation chapter 22.
Revelation 21, right? My fault.
Revelation 21.
21 and read verses 22 and read that through 25.
Come. This is the book of Revelation chapter 21 and verse 22. And I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are in the temple of it. And the city of the Asalat in the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon to shine. For the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. Verse 24. And the nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it. And the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor into it. Verse 25. And the gates of it shall not be shut at all by the day, for there shall be no light there. And they shall.
Exactly. Now this is the new heaven. Right after God cast away the sea, after the judgment, after billions are cast into the lake of fire, he talks about the gates. Now go back to Ezekiel 48. So God says that Ezekiel is going to have land in the new kingdom, and they got to have a gate. Go to Ezekiel 48 and read verse 32.
Ezekiel chapter 48 and verse 32. And at the east side, 4,500. And three gates, and one gate of Joseph, and one gate of Dan of Benjamin, and one gate of Dan.
Now, how in the hell they don't have Dan on the chart? This is comical, man. It's pitiful and it's sad. Excuse me, it's sad at the same time. It's sad and it's pitiful, man. They done totally forgot about Dan when God says he has not put away Dan. He mentions Dan first in Ezekiel as having land in the new kingdom. Let's go back to Revelation 14 one more time, and we be done. Revelation 14, one more time, we be done.
Revelation chapter 14 and what?
Yeah, I'm going to read it. Right here, Revelation 14, verse 4. It says here about 144,000, and these are they which were not defiled by women, which like those 144,000 babies that were slaughtered by Herod the Great. We said, well, how can Herod slew so many babies in one day or a few days? Well, guess what? If you go to the book of Chronicles, you guys can write this down. When you go to the book of Chronicles, chapter 13, and read verses 4 through 20, when the tribe of the northern kingdom had a war with the southern kingdom, it said that 500,000 men died in one day. A half a million men died in one day. So yes, it was possible for Herod to slaughter all those babies, because it says he slew babies from the age of 2 years old and under
from the area of Bethlehem all the way to the coastlines in Judea, all over Judea. So they were the first fruits. So let me read one more time. These are they which were not defiled by women, for they were virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb wherever he goes in heaven. These were redeemed from among men on the earth because they were slaughtered. These being the first fruits because they were the first martyrs. These babies, all these innocent babies that was killed by Herod the Great, they were the first martyrs, the first fruits unto God and the Lamb. Verse 5. And in my mouth, in their mouths was found no guile, for they are without fault. Only children is without fault. Only children are without fault, whether you are a eunuch or not, right? It says before the throne of God. So there you have it. There you have it right there. Like I said, you can take this and you can not believe it, or you can believe it. You can go back and look over these scriptures, or you can't. It's up to you. But from my understanding, the 144,000 were all those innocent baby boys. That's why it says these are males. That's why it doesn't list females. All these innocent baby boys were slaughtered on the account of the Messiah. So guess what? They became the Messiah's first fruit. That's why it says from the four winds of the earth, in the book of Ezekiel, holding the four winds, they blew the four winds, or those four winds blew the breath back into those slain first. They was risen first. They will be risen first because they were the first fruits of the Messiah. So what I want to do quickly, right? I just want to go over something that I forgot to touch last night, right? So let's go to Revelation 7. So this is very vital also. I think I already proved last night who really the 144,000 is. Like I said, I told people to go and just examine the scriptures that I brought out last night also, right? But let's quickly go back to Revelation 7, right? And read verse 1.
Yeah. This is Revelation chapter.
Right, exactly. This is just the continuation of last night, verse. So this is part 2, the seal of the deal. You know what I'm saying? The seal of the deal for all the naysayers out there, right? Yeah, so yes, read Revelation 7 and verse 1.
This is Revelation chapter 7, verse 1, and reads on this wise. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind shall not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree.
Exactly. So it's very vital. It says, I saw four angels. That's four angels, right? On the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds. Each angel had the wind. Four angels had wind, because these four angels are going to blow the breath inside the 144,000 that was the first fruits, right? The first fruits, like I said, when we go back to Revelation 14, right? I'm just going to read it real quick. Revelation 14, verse 4, right? It says, and these are they which were defiled by women. We know that we all have been defiled by women, if you're not a virgin. For they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb whatsoever he goes, just like little toddlers and babies. What do toddlers and babies do in the house? Don't they follow you wherever you go?
They follow you in the bathroom.
Thank you. Yep. So these 144,000 that were slain by Herod the Great, all these male babies slain on the account of the Messiah, they follow him wherever he goes. John is seeing this in the vision. Then it says, and these were redeemed from the earth among men. If there was murder, this is being the first fruits unto God, to the Lamb, right? So when you go back to Revelation 7, again, it says, after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four angels, four winds, right? Holding the four winds of the earth, right? And then it says that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. Now let's go to Ezekiel 37. Four angels, and each angel have wind. Four angels, four winds. He said, don't blow or destroy the earth yet. Don't do it yet. God said, don't destroy the earth or the sea, etc., until I tell you to seal the 144,000 first being the first fruits, as mentioned in Revelation 14.
Done.
Now let's go to Ezekiel, right? This is what I forgot to add last night, because I thought you might go on again. I wasn't really sure if I was trying to hear it get through. But it's all good. We back today. So this is Ezekiel 37, right? Do me a favor, Kornoff. Read verse 8 through. We're going to read verse 8 through 12.
Good. This is Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 8, and it reads on this wise. Mm-hmm. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there were no breath in them.
There was breath in them, right? Uh-huh. So when it says the sinews, this is talking about the tissues, the muscles, etc. These are your flesh, etc., coming back together. That's what it means. You see the word sinews. It means flesh, tissues, muscles, etc. That's what it means. Read verse 9.
Verse 9. Then said he unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus says the Lord, our power, come from the four winds.
Stop right there, Kunal. It says, come from the four winds we just read, right? In Revelation 7:1, it said the four angels holding the four winds. This is what Ezekiel is talking about right here. John was prophesying these four angels that Ezekiel prophesied about.
Right.
So when it says the four winds, is talking about these four angels, right? Yeah. Four angels, four winds. They each have wind to blow breath into these dry bones, right? Continue.
Right.
When it says, breath.
Oh, breath, and breathe upon these slain.
Upon whom? Breathe upon slain. Whom? Be slain. That was murdered, killed. So there goes that the unit being 144,000.
Right.
That goes, you know what I'm saying? That's out the door.
And that also goes, people talk about we looking for the 144,000. You know, I mean, right. It's slain.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. These were slain that they may live. Now read 10, but read it slow. Read the rest of the verses slow, because I may be stopping you every now and then. Go ahead.
Gun. Ezekiel 37, verse 10 on this wise. Uh-huh. So I prophesied as he commanded me.
Mm-hmm.
And the breath came into them.
Right.
And they lived.
Mm-hmm.
And stood up upon their feet.
Mm-hmm.
An exceeding great army.
An exceeding great, let me stop you right there. An exceeding, mm-hmm. exceeding great army. These 144,000 being the first fruit. Now, who killed the children of Rachel? Rachel weeping for her children, right? All those boar babies that were slaughtered. Who killed them? What army? Herod the Great army. His army slaughtered them, right? So this is going to be some revenge right here. So not only were these baby boys slaughtered, and they're going to be the first fruit to be risen. They're the first to be risen before the nation of Israel. I'm going to show you. They're the first to be risen. And they became part of his army. They died as babies, but guess what? They're coming back as men to be part of his army. And they were slaughtered by what? A army. A Herod the Great. Read verse 11.
Then he said unto me, son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Behold, they say our bones are dry,
and
our hope is lost.
I didn't mean to cut you off right there. They said our hope is lost because they were slaughtered. They was murdered by Herod the Great. Continue.
We are cut off for our parts.
Stop right there. It says we are cut off. We are cut off That's just a saying. Also, they was murdered. They was killed. So in verse 9, it says these were slain. Now they are speaking now. These dry bones, these 144,000, which were all those male babies that were slaughtered by Herod the Great. Now they speaking to Jeremiah. They said that we was cut off. They know that they was murdered. They know that it was murdered. We was cut off. They said that we was cut off for our part. Now, after they said this to Jeremiah, right?
Right.
Read verse 12.
Verse 12 on this wise. Therefore prophesy and say unto them,
stop right there.
Says the Lord.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. They said, it says, therefore prophesy and say unto them. So now God is telling Jeremiah to talk back to these 144,000 that now can speak. He said, now say to them. Now, I just showed you, they was risen first, right? They was risen first. Now, watch what God tells Jeremiah. Ezekiel now is going to talk back to these 144,000. Now, look what Ezekiel tells them in verse 12. Read verse 12.
Therefore, prophesy and say unto them, thus says the Lord, our power. Behold, O my people, I will open your graves. And cause you to come up out of your graves and bring you into the land of Israel.
Exactly. So after the 144,000 said to him that we was cut off, meaning we was murdered, God said, say back to them. So Ezekiel said to them, he says, thus says the Lord God, behold, my people, meaning the rest of Israel, the rest of your people, they will also be risen from the grave. And they will be brought back to their land, showing you that the 144,000 were the first to be risen because they were the first fruits of the Messiah. So that's just the icing on the cake. That's it.
That's and all. They knew no women.
No women.
If you go back in the first lesson, they knew no women, and they were virgins. This didn't have a damn thing to do with no unit. And you know, I don't know if you want to do it. I got the notes on it. I have to look it up. But we can go to another lesson. We're going to do a class on units. Right? Yeah, so everybody going to say what they're talking about. And if not tonight, maybe tomorrow, we're going to do a lesson on the so-called reincarnation or regeneration so y'all can have a proper understanding what it's actually talking about there. You know, what it's talking about.
So the recap, verse 9, Ezekiel of God said that these were slain. It was murdered. That's the recap. Verse 2, right? He said, God said, these are from the nation of Israel. These dry bones. Now verse 11. They speaking back to Ezekiel. They says to Ezekiel, they said, we have no hope because we was cut off, meaning they was murdered. And then God says to Ezekiel to say back to them in verse 12, therefore, prophesy and say back to them, thus says the Lord, O my people, that even the other Jews or the rest of the tribe or the rest of the people, they will also be risen from their grave and brought back to the land. Right? But showing you that the 144,000, they was risen first.
Right.
They were the first fruits. So there you have it. There you have it. You can take it, like all I said, crazy. You can go back and re-examine it for yourselves, whatever, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is.
Right. And everything we teach, brothers and sisters, I will say this, you know what, you study it for yourself. Children say, study, show thyself approved unto the Father, unto the Most High, not unto man, and pray for the increase. You know, that you will receive the understanding, you know, and if we're wrong, then you know you can come back and tell us.
Exactly. Right? But go examine it for yourself. Let's read it for yourself.
Right.
Go back to part one from last night and part two. Write all those scriptures down that I brought out and just go back and examine it for yourself. That's it.
Good. So with that, man, we say it's real short. We're going to keep it that way. Bless you all. Again, 6 o'clock. We coming on again at 6 o'clock. I don't know how long that's going to last, but you know we usually do Sunday Night Fire
a little bit after 9. So we're going to do that. So, yeah, it's going to be a busy day. You know, I'm kind of free right now, so it's up to Yehuda. You know, we'll click off and come back in and do something else because we got, man, hundreds of classes that we haven't released yet that we want to do.
Honestly, man, I was doing some studying myself. So we'll get to some more lessons. Enjoy the rest of your day. Until you go back on tonight. And but we'll definitely do the reincarnation for sure. Yeah,
no doubt. Most High bless you all.
Yes. Grace and peace. We'll talk later.
Grace and peace. Most High bless you all.
All right. Sure.